This video is brought to you by Zarkan Productions, an umbrella group composed of over 10 YouTube shows, an archive of over 4,000 videos covering a wide variety of topics, and businesses both inside and outside of Second Life. Please go to zarkan.com for a complete listing of media links, follow us on Facebook and Twitter for our activity feed, subscribe to us on YouTube for future updates, and please support us on Patreon. Thank you for your time, and may I present another Zarkan production.
The other things go flying as well. Yep, this is a special Ladies' Day edition of FWF Untamed. Also, a quick reminder before we start the show, that next week we will not be on our regular Friday time slot. Instead, we will be on Saturday, our next show will be Saturday the 27th, at the same bat time, same bat place, same bat channel of 1 o'clock Second Life time. This will be a special live show, screened in front of a convention audience in Brookfield, Wisconsin at the furry convention known as First Square. For those of you that don't know where Brookfield is, that's in the suburbs of Milwaukee. Welcome everybody to a special FWF Ladies Day edition of Untamed. I, of course, am your CEO and host, Maynard von Schnauzer, calling the action here. And our referee, Wolfie, is looking ready to go. Yep, today is a special four-woman tournament to crown a new FWF Women's Champion. And I think our women are ready to go here. This is a semi-final contest. Anyways, the semi-final contest is set for one fall. Introducing first out of Parts Unknown, Wyoming, at a weight that is none of your bitchness, Sandy Bitch. Referee with some encouraging words for Sandy before our match begins. And now, here comes her opponent, making her FWF debut from Parts Unknown at a weight of 125 pounds, Nixie Doll! As a reminder, this is a semi-final matchup. The winner of this match will proceed to our main event to contend for the vacant FWF Women's Championship. There's the bell. This match is now officially underway. The two wrestlers circling each other at the start here. Pretty much scanning for an opening. And there's the lockup. And Sandy takes the early offense with the forearm club. And off the rope she goes, rebounding with a shoulder block. And Nixie catches Sandy on the noggin with a nip-up headbutt. Yeah. think much you got. It looks like it took a well more of a toll than on Sandy than she expected. Must be hiding something under that hat. Now locking up with Sandy. Just a reminder, Sandy Bitch is a 12-time FWF Women's Champion from our Furcadia years. So she is definitely no rookie at this sport. And now a show of experience as she gets her with that atomic drop. But misses with that fist drop. It looks like she's about to pay for that mistake. A European uppercut from Nixie. Showing that she can brawl too here. Now stomping away. And here's a cover, but only a one count. Nixie now picking Sandy back up. Sandy sends her running to the corner. Follows up with a corner splash. Yeah, sometimes your corner can be a corner can turn into your best friend or your worst enemy. In this case, looking like a best friend for Sandy here, worst enemy for Nixie. She now goes up to the second rope, punching away. But Nixie catches her and power bombs her down. And we got a cover here. Only a two count. Nixie dragging Sandy to the center of the ring. And nice club to the back there. up she goes. And catches her with a high knee. Now stomping away at Sandy. And here's another cover. Only a two count. It appears that Nixie didn't quite approve of the referee's counting there. She picks Sandy back up, who catches her with a spinebuster into the pounding. And now we got some catfighting action in the middle of the ring. A little pulling action as the ref checks for claw use. And now more struggling for momentum between the two. And apparently, Sandy having to remind the ref that this isn't a pin attempt, as he was trying to count. I think he needs to open his eyes a little bit. And apparently we got a botch spot there. A little miscommunication. Tried to pull the head off, but apparently Nixie won none of that. Now Sandy making her pay for that one. And into a fisherman suplex. And a pin attempt. Referee totally missed the count on that one though. Now Sandy picks her back up, but ooh, a rake to the eyes from Nixie. Nixie looking a little angry there. Now a kick to the midsection. A and sends her down with another brutal high knee. Now, Nancy picking her back up. But Sandy firing back with some dirty moves of her own here. And now a cover. Only a two count. Now she picks Nancy back up. And an Irish whip, but Nancy not budging. Up there she goes. Off the rope she goes, catching her with a spear. Now picks her up. And slams her down with a kneeling pile driver. This could be it. There's the cover. One, two, and three. The winner of this match proceeding to the finals, Nancy Doll. Well, it's good to see that Sandy's able to return to her feet as she makes her way back to the backstage. Anyways, it is now time for our next semi-final match, set for one fall. Now making her way to the ring. Out of the Great Barrier Desert, She herself is a 15-time FW Women's Champion, Jen Logas. Now, Jen is quite an experienced veteran of the FWF. She has held the FWF Women's title more than anyone else in history. Also, in the years when we used to have our intergender title, she held that title 4 times. Now her opponent, coming from the rabbit hole at a weight of 120 pounds, Tommy McGregor. There's the bell. This match is officially started. As Tommy gets a few more pre-match hops in. It looks like both are ready to go here. As they lock up. And Tommy with the early offense, locking in that wrist lock. Now a wrenching wrist lock to follow up. But Jen now turning the tables with a hammerlock. Got a headlock from Jen. Tommy counters it with a hammerlock of her own. Some good technical action to start things off here. But Jen overpowers her with that fireman's carry. Now a club to the back. Off the rope she goes. And a sunset flip. But only a one count. Jen helps her back to her feet. Now Tommy with an armbar takedown. I know this is a regular rules match, but it's looking more like a submission match with all these holds here. Now Tommy's standing Jen up. And Jen breaks out of it with a kick to the midsection. Followed by a swinging neckbreaker. And here's the cover. Only a two count. And now an Irish whip to the corner. Knowing Tommy, that can sometimes not quite fare so well. When the Irish whip her to the corner. But Jen staying on the offensive with the corner chop. And now taking it to her with a combo of knee and paw strikes. And ending with the snake eyes. Now Jen shoves her back into the corner. Off the other corner she goes. But Tommy catches her with a push-up head scissors. And takes her down with it. You can tell that took some toll on Tomi as well, favoring her back. But she's able to return to her hind paws. Off the rope she goes and catches her with a shining black. And now some stomps there. Oh, by a cover. Only a two count. Tomi looking like she's a little angry after that count. Not a sight I've often seen of her. Jen sneaks the European uppercut. Going back on the offensive here. And now Spinebuster into a bridge pin. Two count. Now a club to the back here. And what's Jen got in mind here? Head toward the corner. And up to the top turnbuckle she's going. And airborne she goes. But Tomi catches her with a nasty drop kick. That might knock a few teeth out. Both women down now as the referee starts to count. Referee up to five. But the women now starting to show a little movement. Jen uses the ropes to get back to her feet. Now Tomi back up to a knee. So this match will continue. There will be no draw. Now, front face lock from Junior. A cartwheel escape. And an Irish whip. And nasty kick by Tommy there on the rebound. Jen's looking like she might be out of it here. And now Tommy McGregor heading up to the top turnbuckle. And bouncy she goes. And apparently connects there. Here's a cover. One. Two. And three. The winner of this match advancing to the final, Tommy McGregor. Two very brutal matches to start things off here. Now there will be a slight break before our main event here, so they should have a little bit of time to recover. Oh, as a quick reminder, next week we will not be on Friday. Our next show will be Saturday the 27th at the 1 o'clock Second Life time slot. This will be a special live screening show where we will be broadcasting out of the Furry Convention First Squared in Brookfield, Wisconsin, screening the show to a live audience there. Also, we do have plenty of openings if you want to wrestle, commentate, referee, or perhaps do other things here at FWF. Application boxes can be found on the two trusses next to me, as well as at the main entrance, next to the ramps. We'll be right back. this is a little odd for a women's show. We got Gator Dunn coming to the ring with a mic and paw. Apparently he's got something to say here. You can cut my damn music now. Thank yous. Now, I know this is supposed to be Ladies' Day, but don't worry. As you can see, I ain't dressed for wrestle today because, well, I know they ain't gonna give me a match today. I believe after last week that I is entitled to a little rematch, you know, to get my little interspecies belt back. So the reason I'm here is hopes that the management can do the right thing and grants me that rematch. Considering that it's not, the decision on whether or not to grant you a rematch is out of my paws. That is solely up to your new interspecies champion as of last week, the Alley Cat Brad Correia. But don't worry, I have seen the Alley Cat backstage. I'm pretty sure we can bring him out here to give you your answer. is up. I know he's back here. Yeah, apparently some technical difficulties backstage. We know Brad Kariah is in the building, he's just not coming out. Not sure what's going on back there. Waiting a response from him here. He's finally making his way out. Or maybe not. Well, we're going to play music one more time to see if he'll come out here. Thank you. Dad, what's the deal back there? What, did your color change pink to yellow? Can't give me a simple yes or no on the rematch! We really don't know what the delay is here with Brad. Now staff in the back is saying that he's left the building, so I guess we'll have to wait until after the show for his response, because we are really running out of time on this segment. It's alright, I'm gonna get an answer from that chicken shit one way or another. He thinks he can invade the Gator Man. He obviously doesn't know my hunting skills. Anyway, it looks like we're gonna have to get a response on the Facebook page after the show on whether or not Brad Correa accepts the challenge. In the meantime, it is time for our main event. This match is scheduled for one fall and is for the vacant FWF Women's Championship. Introducing first, out of parts unknown, she weighs in at 125 pounds, Nixie Doll! and her opponent. Weighing in at 120 pounds, coming from the rabbit hole, Tommy McGregor. Referee saying Nixie is clean here. And it looks like he's about set to go. Just waiting the bell here. These two women have never held the FWF women's title or any FWF belt in the past here. So we are guaranteed to see a brand new FWF Women's Champion, no matter who wins this contest. They lock horns. We are underway here. As Nixie starts things off with a wrist lock. And follows it up with a strike to the back. Kick to the midsection. Followed by a high knee. That can chip a buck tooth. Nixie picks her back up. Locking in the wrist lock. Really trying to work that paw. But Tommy fires back with the cartwheel escape into a wrenching wrist lock of her own. And now an armbar takedown. And now it's looking like advantage Tommy. She now stands up, Pixie. Tommy sends her back down, dropping that arm. I think at the rate they're going with all those arm attacks on each other, one of these two ladies might have to leave the ring with a podcast. They're really working each other's forearms. Now off the ropes goes Tommy. But Nixie catches her with a clothesline. And now a cover. One. And only a one count. And now Nixie brings Tommy back to her hind paws. And starts punching away. Now a chop. And a bionic elbow. That can start causing Tommy to see little carrots circling her head. Now a kick to the midsection. The ropes goes Nixie. And catches Tommy with a spear. Earlier on, we saw the damage that spear did to Sandy Bitch. Question is, how much damage has that just done to Tommy? And she continues to stomp away at the bunny. Honestly, bunny stomping, I don't think is a sport I would get into. Or hobby. Bunnies are too cute. And now an Irish whip as Tommy comes off the ropes and catches Nixie with that Hurricane Rana. Now she picks Nixie back up to her feet. And an Irish whip. Into the corner goes Nixie. Into the corner, sending Nixie down to the mat. But Tommy heavily favoring that back. It's hard to say how much stamina she's got left here. She picks Nixie back up. Locks in that front face lock, dragging her toward the center of the ring. And now a shove, followed by a flipping armbar takedown. Now Nixie trying to bite the bunny. I'm pretty sure the referee won't stand for this very long. As if he caught the biting. And now we got a warning from the referee on it. And Tommy picks her up with the... still in that armbar. You can tell she's a little frustrated from that jump. But Nixie locks in that front face lock. The referee might want to make sure that the hair and the ears aren't being tugged. But there's a strike to the back. Working on Tommy's weak spot there. Her back has been looking rather tender in this match. And now a club to the back. Yeah, if this keeps up, Tommy might need a chiropractor after this match. Oh, and a fisherman's suplex to do more damage to it. That can send your back for a shell shock in a heartbeat. Tommy McGregor looking to be in worlds of pain here. But now Nixie apparently losing her focus as she taunts to the crowd. Now Tommy's starting to slowly get back to her high paws. Nixie might want to look out behind her. And off the ropes goes Tommy and catches her with a bulldog. You can tell that Tommy is still working through a lot of pain. And she gets back up to a knee. Now stomping in anger at Nixie, and for good reason. I mean, I don't know about you, but I myself don't like being bitten. That's an easy way to trigger my anger. And now, a moonsault off the ropes from Tommy. And here's a cover. One. Two. Only a two count. Close near fall for Tommy McGregor there. It looks like Nixie is the first back to her feet, or at least up to her knee. We have a headline from NXT. Into the corner goes Tony here. Tony quick to slip out of that headlock. That's one advantage a small buddy definitely has, is they can be very evasive. Nixie growling in frustration. Looks like she has that bunny right where she wants her. Now smashing the bunny's head against the top turnbuckle. And Tony McGregor now favoring the noggin as well. I think win or lose, she's definitely going to need a good masseuse after this match. She's been taking a lot of punishment. Tommy catching Nixie with the push-up head scissors. One of her signature moves. And flips Nixie over with the head scissor takedown. That could have been the turnaround. That could be the turnaround that Tomi's been looking for. It looks like her back is still in worlds of pain here. It's hard to say if she'll be able to capitalize. Now Nixie slowly makes her way to her feet. And Tomi's still on the mat favoring that back. Now she starts to rise. Tell she's having a hard time shaking out the cobwebs there. Might have landed wrong from that head scissor takedown. Might have bumped her own noggin in the process. So it's starting to look like. And now a headbutt! Some half-to-head action there. Now following up with the right to the eyes. Now punching away at the bunny. Well, she said she likes to eat bunnies for breakfast. It looks like she's trying to tenderize the bunny first. Now a kick to the midsection. Followed by another brutal high knee. And now a vicious stomp here. The referee might want to check Tomi for injury there. She's not moving too well right now. And now she picks Tomi up. Whip off the ropes goes Tomi. As Nixie follows up with a clothesline. And now a spine buster. Capitalizing on that tender back of Tomi McGregor. Now Nixie picks Tomi back up. And into a backbreaker! That could be all she wrote for Tomi here. Nixie might have this in the bag if she's able to capitalize here. Here's the cover. One. Two, but Tomi kicks out just in time. This match is still going, folks. Tomi may be down, but it looks like she's not out. Nixie picks her back up. Off the ropes goes Tomi. And catches her with an eat me. Got a submission maneuver here. But Nixie counters it with a sidewalk slam. This is definitely the most brutal beating I've seen Tomi take since coming to FWF. And here's another cover. One. Two. And only a two count. This bunny is not giving up. You can tell both competitors are heavily exhausted here. As Nixie picks up Tomi, but Tomi catches her with a jawbreaker! Dummy McGregor has just turned the tables there. Now, can she capitalize? She returns to her hind paws. Both of these women are heavily winded. But then again, you know, they're both doing two matches in one day, so that has got to take its toll on the stamina. Off the ropes goes Tommy, and catches her with a shining black. Now Tommy heading up to the top turnbuckle. We all saw what happened last time she went airborne. And she connects with a bouncy. Here's the cover. One, two, and three. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. The winner of this match and new FWF Women's Champion, Tommy McGregor. Tommy McGregor is your winner here. You can tell that match was very brutal and grueling. Still not quite back up to both hind paws. She is holding an FWF Women's Championship. Well, anyways, that concludes this week's edition of FWF Untamed. We hope to see you again next week on Saturday instead of Friday. Same Matt time, same Matt place, same Matt channel.